Unfocused.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, those fireworks are fucking up the show.
Yeah, we broke it with our awesomeness.
Yeah.
I'm T.
I'm AJ Twist.
And this is Unfocused episode 300.
300.
And 300 is the Pokemon Skitty.
No?
It is, but I'm just disappointed.
It's a weak-ass name.
I know. For 300th, you know?
Yeah, this was a big moment for us. Dude.
Yeah,
we get
for
Skitty.
Us.
You should have a bottle of Skittles, at least.
Skitty is the kitten Pokemon and a weak-ass looking one. I guess this is cute, I guess. You know, we're lucky. We got DJ for the 300th episode.
What up?
Welcome back.
And
I'm here, too.
Yeah, he's here, I guess. Don't forget. Unfocused is available on Stitcher and
Spotify,
Apple Podcasts.
Yeah,
you can also contact us on Twitter at Unfocused28. Email
all that stuff. Yeah,
all that stuff.
Apparently, yeah. 5 days ago, we weren't even doing the show. 5 days ago, we weren't doing anything on the channel. 5 days ago, but someone called Incredible Hulk 420 followed us.
Oh,
when we weren't even here.
Shit.
Cool. Thank you. If you've come back. Anyone else do that while we're gone? No, just that.
We appreciate that. If only that could just keep happening.
Right, we can just not be here and just get, like, you know, subscribers and followers. By the way, subscribe to us on twitch.tv/closer28.
And thank you, Incredible Hulk. What?
Yeah.
420?
420, yeah, for following. Mm. Not subscribing. You can do that too, though.
Right.
And youtube.com/unfocusedpodcast.
Mm. That being said, let's talk about our Unfocused Weeks. DJ, you want to kick us off? What you been doing this past week?
This past week, I just finished watching Invincible.
Oh,
me too.
Oh,
shit. We're going to have an Invincible talk later, yeah. Okay?
Oh, I bet you this conversation will be Invincible.
Will it, though?
But other than that,
Cinco de Mayo. Me and
oh, yeah.
Cinco de Mayo. For
right, right.
With some water.
May the, what was it, Revenge of the Fifth?
Oh, yeah. May the 4th, too.
They had water. Oh, and May the 4th be with us yesterday. Yeah, you're
yeah.
Right. Yeah, don't worry. They had water on the Cinco de Mayo. They needed that.
Yeah, for sure. To make their ice.
Wow. Wow.
But that's it. Like.
That's it.
Yeah.
No.
Slow.
No video games. No reading.
Same video games.
Okay, AJ.
Yeah. You know, same thing. Same video games. Also watch Invincible. I also started watching something new.
You did? What'd you watch?
I watched the first 4 episodes of Demon Slayer.
Oh shit, what do you think?
It's pretty good.
Right?
Yeah. I can tell I'm sipping on a margarita dip. Thanks for asking. It's the first 4 episodes seemed like
Michelada for me.
It seems like it was a bunch of episodes of manga or a bunch of chapters of manga just condensed really quick just to get you into the story. Because it's mostly this guy, kind of the backstory of the main dude and him getting like his training and all that, right? And learning about demons and all that.
Right.
That's what the first 4 episodes was about and him getting his, I guess, him becoming an actual demon slayer going through the trials and all that.
You seen this one, DJ? Demon Slayer?
No, but you told me last week about it.
Okay. All right. Go on, AJ. Tell
yeah.
Us.
So I watched that. I mean, it's pretty cool. It's interesting so far. One thing that the one dude started doing that hasn't been explained yet is like when he's attacked, he has water attacks coming out of his sword. I'm not sure if that's just his imagination type of thing going on there or if he's actually doing some water attacks.
His aura. I seen it.
Yeah. Right.
It was orange.
Actually, yeah, it was.
I think the water is his aura.
That's his like aura. Okay.
Like his nature. You know, I don't think it's actual water.
Okay. All right, then.
But it looks dope, okay. Huh?
Yeah, like I was wondering too. Like, is he actually doing water attacks, or is this like just something that you know we're just seeing visually that's not physically there? You know?
Yeah. I think that's what it is.
Okay.
I could be wrong because who knows? Maybe later on he'll actually start like throwing waves out and stuff. But for now, it seems to be what you thought.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah, and then he fought that first big monster, the one demon who had killed the other, like, you know, those kids that he was training with. And I was like, fuck. I was like, yeah, how did he break that rock? That doesn't make sense. I guess it does. And then that happened. I was like, oh, okay. That was pretty
right?
cool.
For real. Yeah. I was like, damn, that shit really got me too. I was like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
They weren't even alive.
Yeah, that was crazy. Like when he was taking off and he told the old dude, he was like, hey, like, let those two, I said, you know, goodbye or whatever. He's like, what? How does he know the dead? I was like, oh, shit.
dun, dun.
Yeah. For reals. So, yeah, I've been watching that, and I'll continue watching it soon. It's like one season, right? So I'm not... So I ain't never scared of one season, you know?
No, yeah. And like I said, I feel like it's just Inuyasha done right. Like, Inuyasha's good, but like...
Too long?
Too long. A lot of shit that doesn't matter. A lot of filler. Like,
Yeah.
Characters going through plots that don't take them anywhere, and then they go right back. Like, I hate that shit. But this one feels like Inuyasha, but streamlined, and like everyone has a plot and everyone matters. Like, you know, because that's the other thing about Inuyasha. If you weren't Inuyasha or Kagome, you weren't really going to matter against the main villain you're fighting, you know?
Yeah, you're the plot of a song by Linkin Park. Which, doesn't really matter.
Wow. but yeah, okay. So.
Also, I started like watching videos and learned how to play that UFS, that Universal Fighting System card game.
You're still fighting for it, okay.
Yeah, so I've been learning how to play and actually put together a Shanghua deck since Shanghua was a character card that I drew out of one of my boxes. So I just got a bunch of cards that I think work together. I haven't been able to play anyone yet because I don't know if anyone wants to learn to play with me or not. But, you know, I have a deck ready.
To hear.
Man, I'm barely playing Digimon, still getting into that.
Well,
which I did actually make a deck and played some matches with DJ Ray and... Oh, wait, yeah. Is it my turn? You done?
Yeah, that's pretty much what I did.
Yeah, I actually made a deck for Digimon, played some matches, you know, I did the whole thing. That was part of my Unfocused week. We got to play a little bit.
Yep.
DJ and AJ were teaching me. Now I get how the game works and I can actually play it. I don't know if I could do any tricky shit yet. I have to play a few rounds.
We can barely do tricky shit, so...
Okay, yeah, it's going to take a while, I guess.
We can play some more after the...
Yeah.
I'm dumb. I'm still... it sucks this next day off. I'm going to be so busy because I really want to spend like just at least a couple hours hunting for some fucking Digimon cards.
I've been randomly like going to shops, seeing if they have anything. Most shops I've been to recently don't have shit. I went to a shop today. Actually, I bought this today. I found another boss monster expansion pack. I was like, oh, fuck yeah, this is one I don't have. So I picked it up to add to the collection.
Mm. Other things. I've been playing Splatoon.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I've been playing that a lot lately. Because I got my pro controller. Fucking, this shit's so much fun to play. It's not like the other one where, like, I want to win, but it's a chore. But, you know, now it's gone already.
Damn it.
Yeah, I want, like, when playing it with that fucked up regular Wii controller was like a... Do you want to play? You're having...
Now it's fucked up in regular now.
Yeah, it's not even regular. It was falling apart on me. I think I mentioned last week.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it was fucked up. And I was like, I want... Every time I was going to turn from Splatoon, I was like... I want to play, but I know I'm not going to enjoy it completely because, like, sometimes I lose because of the fucking controls, you know? Like, you know, when you get real good at that at Splatoon, every movement actually starts to matter.
Yeah.
And when you slip up or your thumb slips off because it doesn't have a fucking thing on a little
like
top
a
on
grip,
it.
Yeah.
A grip, like, that sucks. And it just kind of, you get splatted there, and then maybe your team loses right there, and you're just like, damn. So that's a burn.
Yeah. It's like playing fighting games. Like, you know, when I'm learning a fighting game, like, I'm just learning it, fucking doing shit. But once I start fucking knowing what I'm doing, I start to feel the flaws in my arcade stuff. I was like, whoa, okay, this corner's not hitting like when I think it should be hitting, or this button doesn't respond as quick as I think it should be responding.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, so, like, once you master a game, then you start to feel the little things that you didn't realize before.
Mm-hmm. So there's that. Been playing, so with the pro controller, it's just a lot more fun, so I've been really getting into it, and, like, climbing up the ranks better, because I don't have as many of those fucking little stupid-ass mishaps, you know? But yeah, you know, just trying to get my strategy down better. Trying to get that retreating strategy down. Like, you know, right when you think you should throw more bombs or run in, like, you should actually just back up a little bit and kind of see what's going on.
Yeah.
But anyway, other than that, I played a good amount of Soul Calibur last week with AJ and by myself a little bit.
Oh, we did do that, yeah.
Yeah, by myself a little bit, too. We still didn't fucking win.
Oh, no.
But, you know, oh, well.
Chris took it.
Yeah, Chris took the hammer.
Oh, yeah, you were there. That's right. You know what happened. Mm-hmm. You saw what happened. You're a part of it.
Part of it. I got defeated. Other than that, I think that's about it. Did I do anything else for the Unfocused week? I started watching Superman and Lois on HBO Max.
You know, I just discovered that was on HBO Max.
It's good.
I only saw the first episode.
I'm almost done with the first episode. Like 10 minutes left. Mm-hmm. It's fucking good.
It's pretty good, huh?
It's really good.
Yeah, I want to see it too.
I feel like they took a cue from Doom Patrol and Titans and Stargirl, you know? Like, they saw those, how they work, and they stopped doing their CW bullshit and just fucking made a show. You know, like, it's good. You know, so I really like it.
Okay, that's cool.
I think... that's mostly it for my Unfocused week. Shall we jump into some other stuff?
Should we talk about, like, Invincible by any chance?
You okay, yeah. All right, so I'm starting to feel like we should make a new segment for reviews.
We've been getting some good shit recently, and, like, we never had to
do
this so often.
Yeah, but, you know, we would always do it fairly, like, every now and then. So yeah, maybe we should have a section movie for reviews and stuff, you know? I think it's starting to be a thing.
Yeah.
But anyway, Yeah, we're going to talk a little bit about Invincible and then something else. Like, there's a special Marvel Phase 4 trailer that's coming out, so we'll talk about that too.
Should we do a spoiler for Invincible?
Yes. Oh, 100% yes. For anyone who's not read the comic or not seen the show or not finished the show or the comic, please, this is a spoiler alert.
Yes.
RS Misfit, what up for the 300th episode?
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Happy 400. Thank you. It is our 300th. We somehow made it this far, and it feels no different. All right, I got to change this. All right, yeah. So, yeah.
One day someone important's going to stumble onto our storehouse of shit and just fucking get obsessed and listen to all our shit. And then, like, you know what? I got to tell everyone to watch this shit, you know?
Eventually.
Elon Musk, you know? He's going to just stumble onto our shit and be like, you know what?
That'd be sick.
I'm going to tell everyone to watch this. This shit's pretty good.
How the fuck do you spell Invincible?
With an I.
With an
I. I-N-V-I. C-I-B-L-E.
Oh, okay. That's all it is.
That all right, so
more complicated than
Invincible
that.
Is the animated show based off of the comic book on Netflix. I'm sorry, on Amazon Prime. It's 45-minute episodes every time. It was an 8-episode season. The 8th episode just premiered this past Thursday, and we've all seen it, so we're going to talk about it a little bit. So if you don't want to know, tune out, because there's big spoilers in this one. Like, seriously, like, it'll fuck the whole thing up for you. All
right. We're not trying to do that right now.
Invincible. What'd you think? DJ, tell us something, man.
It was awesome.
Great. To you, AJ. What do you think about it?
It was scary.
Knowing nothing about it. Yeah, it was scary, wasn't it? Fucking Nolan was fucking scary.
Yeah.
No, you know, I like they used that moment. There was a Dragon Ball Z moment. They've done this in Dragon Ball. They show the characters as two little dots bouncing around.
Yeah.
But they did it perfectly with this one. And they showed, like, Nolan was a red dot and Invincible was a blue dot. Mm. And they show, like, he was, like, fucking flying everywhere around and bouncing around like fucking, like a pinball, but the ball is the knocker. Yeah. You know, and he was like knocking him around everywhere, and you're just like, damn, that really tells you the gravity of what's happening right now.
Yeah.
And
yeah, and just because this show was like so like graphic too, like you really got to see like how much he was messing up Invincible. Like he was just fucking bloody, fucking swollen, and just coughing up blood and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And
dude
was practically, yeah, he almost died. Mm-hmm. He was like one punch away from dying.
Yeah.
And then just the point that Nolan, that Omni-Man was trying to make was like, you know, like...
Humanity's,
you know,
nothing.
Exactly, right. And like, and he kind of proved that by just fucking him up through the world, like through boats, through buildings, and purposely going back and forth through like the boat. Like, you know, the boat, he split it in half to fucking put him on the water, and then came out like the other end. But he didn't, you know, go past the boat. He went through the boat again.
Yeah, he went to fuck it up to show... And it's cool because like he was trying to show Mark how little humanity means to him,
yeah,
and how little it should mean to him, you know, to Mark as well. And there's really good.
And that subway scene too,
bro. That's not that scene's not
crazy.
That part's not in the comic, bro.
It was made for the show.
They made that specific scene just for the show. So even I, as the person who's read this scene, and don't get me wrong, when this happens in the comic, your jaw is dropped just like the show. Like, the fuck? Like he's beating the shit out of him, and then that scene happened, and I was like, whoa, this blows the comic out the water right now. Like, if you slow-mo, you can even see a little girl in his arm run shit, like, it's ran through his arm and blows up, and I was like, wow, they even killed children on this.
Yeah.
Which is usually a big no-no on TV and movies, but, you know, it's animated. Fuck them. We can do anything. We can do it all.
But that's one thing I like about the show, that they actually show, you know, like, the public dying. You know, like, in the other cartoons, you see the superheroes just fighting each other, but you never see the actual community,
yeah,
how they suffer, you know. And in this show, you actually see them like getting squashed and cut in half, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, destroyed. Like, yeah, you know what, I feel like Marvel tries to do that in some way. Like, they don't, like, as battles are happening in Marvel, like, they don't show you all the, like, you know,
the details,
the details in it, but like later on the next movie, you'll see, oh, a lot of these people suffered, and you see those behind the scene type of, you know, on the ground action, all these people like trying to invade. And
Marvel really took it to the next level as far as actually, which, you know, it was very befitting of the comics, because DC was all about them being like gods and champions. They never talked about all the destruction that happens after. And Marvel didn't talk about that much either. But Marvel was always the one to deal with the more real people things.
Because
they had a comic called Damage Control. Yeah. And that was about a company that would clean up all the shit that the fucking superheroes... And that was back in the 60s or 70s, you know? So I like that that echoes in the movies, that they care about those concepts, you know.
I guess Justice League did that too, right? Because Batman was after Superman. Oh, not Justice League. Batman v Superman.
Man of Steel.
Man of Steel did the whole world destruction, but I don't think they showed too much of the people.
Oh, you're right.
But Batman v Superman, they did. Anti Batman was after Superman.
And that was a cool move for them too. Yeah. I was glad they did that.
So they're doing more of that now. But this one just really shows you, like, as it's happening, not afterwards. They show you as it's happening,
like limbs.
Well, in Marvel, like, that's the reason why the Civil War happens. Because remember that team that fight in the school, and that fool like explode, and everyone in that school, elementary school, they all die.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's a good example.
The New Warriors.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But yeah, there's all that happened. That was crazy. And then the end outcome too, when he just kind of just took off. It's like, where the fuck did he go? Do you know what happened to him?
No, because even where I'm at in the comic, he's just gone.
No shit. Okay.
He flew off. I have read a couple issues after, but none of them have told me what happened to Nolan.
Oh, wow.
He just flew off, and like, I'm like, oh, shit, I guess he's gone for now.
Yeah, so he took off. And then what else happened? Oh, the fucking robot dude. Robot tripped me out.
Yo, that was fucking creepy. See, you know what's funny? That part hasn't happened in the comic book yet where I'm at. Mm-hmm. So that was all new information to me. I was like, whoa, because I know he's up to something in the comic. I can tell. He's doing something kind of sneaky on the side.
Yeah.
But I don't think it's on that level. And then I saw that episode, and I was like, yo, what the fuck? I'm like, that's what he's doing? I'm like, that's not very hero-like.
Because he wants to smash. Apparently, like, he likes that little girl that turns into
a goblin. She's not little.
She's in a little person's body.
But yeah, like, I just thought that was a whole cool concept. Like, I've never seen a concept like that where, like, there's a human who's... He actually reminded me of, what's his name in real life? Freaking smart dude in the wheelchair.
Stephen Hawking,
yeah. Remind me of him. Like, imagine Stephen Hawking was, like, just that much more into tech and all that and actually went that far, you know? Shit. Imagine, like, that's kind of what I felt like was going on there. So I thought that was cool. And his whole thing, like, I was wondering what he was doing with the DNA sample. Like, what is he pondering?
Yeah,
I thought he's going to clone every single part of that team. So,
his own team?
Yeah, so they could be a little more disposable, and then he just has a backup that he can just, you know, maybe brainwash a little bit or some
shit.
That's
pretty good, AJ.
That's what I thought he was going for.
That's pretty interesting, actually.
Yeah, like, but it ended up being something completely different. And I was like, oh, shit, like, that's pretty dope.
I don't feel like you could have guessed what he did, because no. Even me reading the comic books, and I knew he's up to something.
Yeah.
I didn't expect it to be that. I was like, oh, shit, that's really...
I thought it was doing something with Omni-Man. That's what I thought.
Yeah.
No, I didn't think that. But that was interesting to see that whole thing going on. And what else was at the end?
You know what else wasn't in the fucking the comic? The whole moment where Cecil came and challenged Omni-Man.
Mm.
I think I talked about that last week, though, huh?
I don't remember.
Where the satellite fired on Omni-Man.
Oh, that was sick,
and
yeah.
And Cecil had that teleporter.
I don't think he talked about
Dude,
that. No.
None of that was in the comic.
No.
Like, Cecil doesn't even show up until after Omni-Man beats the shit out of Mark.
Mm.
Then Cecil shows up and says, oh, yeah, I'm the guy pulling the strings behind your dad and blah, blah, blah. Sure. So, but this one in the show, they let you see him, like, episodes ago, you know? Like,
yeah.
That was pretty cool. It was a nice change up. They did a good job, man.
Yeah, that was cool. Also, like, at the... one thing that was weird, too. I'm not sure if she's just messing around or not, but the one chick he's dating, what's her name again? Amber?
Yeah.
Like, when he kind of went in to admit to her, like, oh, yeah, I'm invincible, like... Did she really know, or was she just saying that?
No, I
just
think
to kind of be like, whatever, I knew that.
No, she knew.
She knew?
I think she knew.
You think she figured it out?
Yeah, for sure he knew. She knew.
Okay.
That means he's not doing a good job being secrecy, you know?
Yeah, he's still like a rookie at it.
Yeah.
And basically, it kind of made it seem like she was in denial, or just trying not to think about it too much, because she knew, obviously, he's fucking leaving for random reasons. But that episode made me like her a lot less. So I was like, man, she's kind of whack now.
Yeah.
I'm like, what? And I'm like, because before I was understanding her feeling behind everything. And now I'm kind of like, and
like,
then
she
got,
you
got back with him. And then you got back with him just because he got his ass beat. And I'm like, man, nah. You know,
it's like, make up your mind. Come on.
Yeah, just make a decision. Don't put him.
Just let him hook up with what's her name? Eve.
Young already, Justice. Man. Thank you for joining us. I don't know who that is.
That's DJ. All
right.
What's up?
See, backwards it says DJ, you know?
Is your new rap
name? DJ.
Young Justice.
Young Justice. That's my online name.
That's funny. I think that is it.
And then the whole water thing, when at the very end, when he's telling him, like, oh, yeah, check out this room. He's like, I can't see anything. He's like, oh, yeah, turn on the lights. And it's like, yeah, you couldn't see shit because we put shit in the water. So certain people can't see, or the rest of the world can't see.
Yeah, that was crazy.
I was like, oh, fuck.
Lights on and lights out. He's like, yeah. And someone told me, because they've read further than me in the comics, mm-hmm. they're like, when he says, you'd be surprised how often we use this, mm-hmm. my friend said, don't forget that he said that. That's going to be a big fucking thing. And I was mm-hmm. like, oh, shit.
But you know what's funny? When I saw that scene, it reminded me when I did shrooms. I tripped out on the whole vibrations of light. I was like, oh, man.
It has like different spectrums. Yeah, of like different spectrums.
Maybe you cleaned out whatever was in the tap water. That's why you're able to see that shit. Yeah. Imagine. Damn.
Well, you know, back in the day, the Native American, our people used to fucking use that shit for healing, you know?
Like, yeah.
Fucking, or, you know, rite of passage and healing, you know? Like, mental healing.
Damn.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but overall, like, just the fact that he mentioned his purpose is so scary. It's like they're the ultimate race in the universe. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's scary.
They can stop them. Like, what are the chances that Earth
and
us have a chance to stop whatever they're planning? You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, and especially like they were like, oh yeah, don't. Now that he's gone, more are gonna come. Yeah. I was like, oh shit.
So what
yeah,
are we gonna do?
That one alien from who's looking for Orath.
Like Alan Alien?
Yeah, he's the one that came through to tell him all that information, which that was cool. And I didn't realize this, but that's Seth Rogen.
Yeah, me too. Okay, I realized that too.
I was just about to bring that up, because do you know who's Robot's voice?
No.
Siler.
Oh, wait, I did know that. My bad. I did know that. Yes, yes.
Siler from Heroes. You know the guy who used to...
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay.
That's Robot's voice.
Crazy.
Yeah.
And you know the Spock. The guy who can make the armor on his skin? Like the black guy that make the armor on his skin? He's like the crime boss
yeah.
now? You know whose voice he is? Fucking Mahershala Ali, Blade.
Oh, what? That's who it is?
The guy who's
oh,
okay. Blade. Yeah, that's him.
Oh, okay, okay.
They got big names for this one. And then Invincible is the guy from Walking Dead.
Yeah. AKA Avatar Wan.
And yeah, that's right. I forgot he's him.
And
yeah.
Omni-Man is that old
J.K.
dude.
Simmons.
He's, yeah.
I met him.
J.J. Abrams. J. Jonah Jameson.
J.K. Simmons, yeah.
J.K. Simmons is J. Jonah
I actually met him when I used to work at Mrs. Fields.
Oh, really?
He came in a few times to buy cookies.
That's cool.
Hey, how are you? And gave him the cookies.
You actually? That's funny.
That's crazy. You should have asked him about his time on Portal and Portal 2. He was also... He was like the old director. His voices were just like living in the audio system of the place and all that. So you get to hear the backstory of Portal and all that. So he was in that too. He's right. The guy who said, "Don't like make life take lemons back. Call for life's manager."
He's like, "Call for life's manager."
Yeah, when life gives you lemon, don't make lemonade. Make life take the lemons back. I don't want your damn lemons. What am I gonna do with these? I forgot the whole thing, the whole bit, but it was pretty funny.
That sounds pretty good. All right, so we're done with Invincible. That's basically it. Season 2, we'll see what happens, right?
Yeah.
No one else has anything they want to say? All right. You can turn the spoiler button off. All right, now we're going to talk real quickly. I guess, is this considered news?
Yeah, it's fucking news.
All right, okay. News.
This is the news.
Let's do it.
The news.
Yeah.
Yeah. The news.
What? Let's get it.
All right, so the thing that we're like alluding to before T took off is... you're talking about the Marvel trailer that Marvel dropped, right?
Yep.
So, Marvel dropped a trailer, which when I first saw it, I didn't watch it right away. But then I started seeing all these ads or pictures of news like, oh, like the new title for Black Panther and all this. I was like, wait, where's this coming from?
Dude, once I saw it was officially from Marvel's YouTube,
yeah.
I always look at it right away, especially in the mornings.
Like, it looked like it was just like another trailer for Black Widow. I was like, nah, I'm good. I'm going to wait. but then like I saw all these other things coming out from like one video. I was like, okay, is this coming from this video? And I went to go watch it, and it was more than just the Black Widow thing. It was little announcements of some other things.
Yeah, it was technically, they always have a, I mean, not always, because I don't think they had it for Phase 1 and 2, but, you know, ever since Phase 3, they have a little, like, a little promo for the phase, you know, kind of introducing what's coming and, like, what they're going to do
it's
with
coming.
It. And, you know, and they end it with the number at the end, you know?
Yeah.
And, but this time, you know, they've released a new one, and it was kind of a surprise drop. And it was specifically about their cinematic stuff, not like their whole phase. It's specifically about the movie experience right now. And it was a surprise drop. What'd you think about it? I mean,
but the only thing is that like it looks like they're gonna leave Fantastic Four at the ending. Like that's gonna be the last release. Mm. Like, no.
Well, let me
tell you,
I really want to see that one.
Well, let me tell you, I think they have there was a message being told to the fans that people didn't quite get in this with this trailer. Right. But we'll talk about it first before I say that. Okay. Okay.
So yeah, I thought this was just like because also like I was seeing a bunch of pictures for like Eternals. I was like, wait. a trailer for Eternals. We haven't had that yet. I'm like, where's this shit coming from? I finally went to Marvel's YouTube page. I'm like, this only video here is this freaking Black Widow one. And then I saw the titles, like, oh, it doesn't say Black Widow in there. Let's check it out. And I finally watched it, and that's when you saw the little clips from Eternals, and just clips of just everything else that we've probably already seen before. And then they start dropping titles for all the videos or all the movies coming out soon. It's like, oh shit, this is a fucking big announcement. Yeah. I like the whole callback too, showing like just that moment in Endgame again. That was cool to see the audience reaction. It's like, oh, that moment in the theater was so good.
Dude, I can't wait to tell you. I can't wait till we're done discussing so I can tell you what I think they're trying to tell us.
I think I'm done with discussing. I just wanted to say all that. You see anything?
There's things to discuss because two big reveals in that trailer.
Should put the video.
I've only
seen it once.
Me too.
Well, yeah, there was two specific big reveals in there, and they were the titles of two movies.
Yes, they were, yes.
And the two big reveals were Black Panther 2 and Captain Marvel 2.
Yes.
Which just happens to be T's favorite two characters.
Oh, true.
Spider-Man. What are the odds, you know? Yeah, but both of the titles are not what we thought they would be.
Marvel is a surprise to me.
I thought both of them were a surprise. Yeah, so I guess Black Panther reflects what we heard, that the next movie was going to basically be about their world and how they're dealing with the whole thing.
Yeah.
And so Black Panther 2 is going to be called Black Panther with the subtitle Wakanda Forever.
Yeah.
Which I'm glad they dropped the numbers after Phase 2.
Yeah.
I'm fucking tired of the numbers.
Like, I don't mind numbers. It helps me keep track of shit.
I think it's better without the numbers because
I think the only one that doesn't have...
You don't want to get to Avengers 12, bro.
I do.
No, but that's redundant, though. Like, you'd rather see Avengers whatever the fuck it's about. Number 12
just the fact
behind
that,
it.
Just the fact that it's Fast and Furious 9, I'm already tired of it.
Yeah, it makes you tired
looking
like, at the number.
I was like, damn, we're 9 already?
Dude, the higher the number, the more exhausted.
After 3, I was already like,
Jesus,
oh my God.
Christ.
Rocky,
yeah, exactly. After
Rocky
3, like,
7, Gum, come on.
Yeah, it's exhausting. Why do you think I haven't seen after Rocky 5? Because it's fucking
seven
exhausting. I'm like, 6, 7, and you know, also because of the movies we grew up on, the more of them there are, the worse they got. Like, Freddy Krueger, Nightmare on Elm Street.
That's different.
The more,
a new era now.
But in your mind, that's how it is. Like, you don't even want to watch it. Saw, you're like, the more of them they are, the more whack they get. You're
Fast and
like,
Furious wag.
Fast and the Furious
Star
wag.
Wars is wags.
Yeah, Star
they
Wars.
They don't number. They just got episode numbers. They got titles. They were never numbered.
Star Wars is a little different. I wasn't talking about Star Wars, but whatever.
But there's only two things that have been numbered in the MCU, and that's
Iron Man 2.
Iron Man 1, 2, and 3, right? And then, I guess, Guardians, Volume 1, Volume 2, Volume 3. Anything else has been numbered? I don't think so.
But I feel like they were going to do it until they realized, like, oh, shit, maybe we shouldn't do
it. I think when they got to Hulk, they're like, wait a minute. Did we call this Hulk 2 or 1? What do we call this shit?
And Thor. Like, I think they just really didn't want to call it Thor 2. Okay, so we learned that Black Panther 2 is called Wakanda Forever. It's not going to be Black Panther 2. Black Panther... subtitle Wakanda Forever. And Captain Marvel is not even going to be called Captain Marvel 2 at all, or Captain Marvel anything. It's called The Marvels.
Yeah.
Which I fucking love that. That's pretty cool.
You think Nova's going to be in that?
Who?
That's what I think. Nova.
Oh, that'd be cool. Well, Nova.
That's what I was thinking.
Well, Nova doesn't. He's not one of the Captain Marvels, though, you know? So. And I think
he's pretty marvelous, though.
I think when they do Nova, they're not going to want to connect him to Captain Marvel because their powers look kind of visually similar. Because I heard that's why Nova's not an Endgame. Because I heard they wanted him in it, but they chose not to put him because visually his powers are similar to Captain Marvel. And they didn't want you to be tired of it. You know, like seeing her streak through the sky. Because remember how dope that was in Endgame when you fucking see Captain Marvel's there? You're like, oh shit. Up, But if you saw Nova doing it the whole time before she got there, you'd be like, that's cool.
You too, okay.
Yeah, you wouldn't care. So I heard that's why they held back on Nova in Endgame. And so now I'm kind of like seeing that. Anyway, moral of the story, The Marvels is the name of the movie.
Yeah, so I want to ask you, T, since we have an actual title for this now.
It looks like her old costume, black costume mask.
It's funny you say that.
So.
You know why that's interesting? Is because that's the same symbol that the new Miss Marvel wears, which is Kamala Khan.
Mm-hmm.
And she's a main character in this movie.
Mm-hmm.
So that's probably her S, or, you know, really... It's a lightning bolt, but yeah, basically an S. And they put that to let you know, yeah, it's both of them, you know?
Cool.
So, T, do you still think your hopes of getting a Rogue in this movie still exist with this title?
You know, with the title, it actually makes me feel like it's more confirmed. And I'll tell you why. Because this movie is not only going to feature Kamala Khan, it's also going to feature Monica Rambeau.
Yeah, true.
And Monica Rambeau was Captain Marvel before Carol Danvers was Captain Marvel. So I feel like it's about everyone who's ever had a connection or tie to Captain Marvel at all, which makes me think more that Rogue might be the villain, because eventually she basically becomes a Captain Marvel, you know, when she drains her power.
Right.
And, yeah, and I think it'd also be really interesting, too, because we know that, you know, Kamala Khan, Miss Marvel, looks up to Carol Danvers. And from what we saw in WandaVision, it doesn't seem like Monica Rambeau feels that way about her right now.
We don't know what she feels like right now, yeah.
No, no, there was twice, remember, already?
There was twice, yeah.
Where she just, like, kind of dismissed Carol altogether and, like, didn't want to talk about her. So, something's going on there. Mm. I feel like we might be seeing dueling perspectives of her, which might even be a commentary about how the fans reacted to the Captain Marvel movie. Mm. Because, you know, it did amazing. It made as much money as almost Infinity War did.
Yeah.
But... you know, there was a little critical backlash, if everyone remembers. Some people didn't like it. I liked it, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, yeah, that was kind of interesting. I wonder if there's, like, a commentary going on there.
Oh, yeah. We'll see, yeah.
Also, we got a first teaser of Eternals, like AJ and DT were mentioning.
Yeah.
Dude, I didn't think Angelina Jolie was going to be fighting and doing crazy-ass fucking martial arts shit. I thought she was going to be maybe like, as a senior actor and someone who's, like, proven as a good actress. Mm-hmm. I thought she was going to be kind of taking a back seat in this movie. It looks like that's more Selma Hayek, not Angelina Jolie. Because the only fighting we see in the trailer is Angelina Jolie fucking shit up.
I was hoping for that scene to come up. Oh, there it is.
Yeah, there you go.
With the sword. Let's
go back a little bit further. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I was like, dude, you get to see almost the whole cast right there. They're only missing two of them.
Yeah.
That looks pretty cool. Looks like there's some kind of cult situation going on behind them. Yes.
You know, Angelina Jolie has a new movie that just dropped too. So I wonder if she has some action going on in that. If you know what I mean, you know. But maybe we can get a glimpse of, you know, what she might be like in this movie. Mm-hmm. And this movie has already been done for like a year now, right?
So yeah, they've just been re-editing it and shuffling the order and, you know, tweaking the story. But the actual shooting has been done.
And holding it off because of quarantine or not because of COVID and all that.
Yeah, that too. But the actual shooting, the filming has been done, yeah. Even the reshoots have been done.
Mm.
Yeah, so Eternals finally got our teaser. If anyone wants to get a look at what this is actually going to look like, you should definitely see this trailer if you haven't yet.
Not much to see, though. Looks like they're suited up. That's about it. Yeah, just little clips.
As I said, teaser.
Yeah it's all teaser, yep.
Okay, so what else did we learn? I don't think we learned anything else new. Everything else is all stuff we knew, right?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know about, like, Ant-Man, like...
Quantum.
You know about Ant-Man and the Wasp? Like Quantumania?
Quantumania, yeah.
Because you ain't been listening to Unfocused.
That's true, DJ.
We covered it.
Yeah.
Get on for it, sure, bro. Man. Yeah, but I actually thought I mentioned it was gonna be Giant Man 3, Guardians 3. So okay, now I can get to my message where I think Marvel's really trying to tell us with this video. So go back to this, you know, go back to the beginning of this video, AJ.
Oh fuck!
But you don't have to watch the whole thing. Just jump around a little bit. Just jump around.
Okay. People.
Anyone looks carefully, look what this seems to be about.
Family.
Family. Look, Wong and his connection with the Ancient One, Vision and Wanda.
Okay.
The theme of this trailer seems to be family, and how Marvel is good at making characters that are not family work together and become family. Look, we are Groot.
Yeah.
So, that being said, usually Marvel ends these little teasers for their phases with a big number of the phase, but this time they ended it with the big blue 4. Almost similar to us, Marvel's first family, we're not going to fuck this up. I think that's what this whole thing is saying. Look, we built families in Avengers, in fucking Guardians of the Galaxy, who you didn't even think was going to be good, Wakanda, and Black Panther, Doctor Strange with his whole legion of, you know, of magic practitioners and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, all these things, like, you know, just all this is Mary all, every, like, him and his dad, look, Peter Quill and his dad, you know? And then all of us, the feeling we felt in movie theaters when we were sitting there with our family watching Endgame, and they're finally tying it all together saying, hey, Marvel's first family, we can't fuck it up. You've seen what we do. We're not going to fuck it up. And I think that was the whole message and why they only showed you the 4 at the end, because they're like, just get that. We're not going to fuck it up. Trust us.
No, I trust them.
Okay.
I know they're going to make Fantastic Four the right way.
I like how they stuck in the fucking cat over here.
Yeah, the Flurkin. He was one of the regular characters. They just I know, it's just funny. He came, like, right after Loki, like, in the... like, he got to Spider-Man, And right before, who like a regular character.
It's the reason why Nick Fury doesn't have an eye.
Yeah.
Last time I trusted someone, I lost an eye.
It was a cat.
He got shown with everybody else for real.
Yeah, like he's an Avenger, man.
Right. So yeah, so keep in mind, I haven't seen anybody. I've seen a lot of people break down this video, you know, like heavy spoilers, new rock stars, all these cool people. No one has pointed out that theme that I think this movie, and they highlight the Black Widow thing, and we know that movie's about family.
Yeah.
They're definitely trying to tell us family is our skill. We got you guys. Don't trip.
Okay.
We'll see. And I also think it's fitting.
You guys heard it here first.
Yeah, you heard it here first.
July 9th.
I also think it's fitting to end it with to end phase four with Fantastic Four and putting the final stamp on the family feel. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, and a lot of you were asking, this is technically a piece of news, so we can jump to something else now. But that's the main thing about this trailer. Look at it if you haven't seen it. They tell you a lot of little things. I highly recommend you guys check this trailer out.
Can't wait for Fantastic Four.
Yeah, no, me either, man. I just want to hear the casting, dude. Once I hear the casting, I'll be like,
yeah,
more happy. The Blade movie has been talked about a lot since this trailer has been dropped.
Family.
I don't know if you heard about that.
Damn, so are we going to get, like, freaking Fast and Furious in this shit, too? Because family?
Imagine when they showed Vin Diesel walking.
They show Groot. I mean, I'm just saying.
Almost there, bro. Almost there. Okay, so, everyone, the first thing people were apparently bitching about was, one, you know, the Fantastic Four, how come all we got was a logo? Then, two, where's Blade? Because Blade got announced last year, you know?
Yeah.
So everyone's like, where's Blade? But me, being the person that really pays attention to what Kevin Feige says, I caught. Feige said last time that was a surprise announcement, the Blade thing.
We're not supposed to tell you that shit yet.
Yeah, he mentioned specifically.
Pretend you forgot.
Yeah, he said specifically, telling us about Mahershala Ali being Blade was a surprise announcement. And he also said that will be in phase five.
True.
And I don't think everyone remembers that, because everyone's like, where's Blade? But it's because he's not in phase four. Mm. He's going to be in the next phase.
Yeah.
So everyone stop panicking, stop freaking out.
Shut the fuck up.
Kevin Feige was very clear. It's coming out next time. Also, the other thing about Blade is that supposedly it was supposed to start its production this year. Didn't mean the filming was going to start this year, but they were going to start putting shit together for Blade this year. That has just recently been officially pushed back, yesterday, I believe. Instead of being set up this fall, it's going to start being set up next year in summer. So Blade is officially now solidified to be phase five, because there's no way it can make phase four by being all the way next year as a beginning point.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, Blade's not going to be phase five. Phase four. Phase five, everyone. AJ, got some news for us?
I guess. I know you kind of have it as news too, but I'll just bring it up since it's all part of Marvel. Loki. So there was like a little teaser that came out, I think today or yesterday. Was it today?
Yes, today. Yeah.
Yeah. It was just freaking Tom Hiddleston talking about hey, Loki's a good guy too. You know, he's not bad, right? He got brushed aside in a couple of movies, but you know, he's good, right? And then pretty much at the end, he's just saying like, oh yeah, by the way, you know, Loki, June 9th, because what did he say? Well, Wednesday's a new Friday. And so they're going to bring out Loki, the show, on Wednesdays, apparently.
Yeah. Which is breaking the pattern of what Marvel has been doing so far.
At least for the last two movies. Yeah.
Last two shows. Yeah. Falcon, Winter Soldier and WandaVision have both been Friday releases. I thought that was going to be the tradition, but like Loki says.
Yeah. So Wednesday's a new Friday.
It's too bad. Marvel was this close to stealing the TGIF block.
Imagine?
I was thinking like when we heard all these TV shows were going to come out, I thought that's what was going to happen, that we were going to have a Marvel Power Hour like the old days.
Mm. That'd be cool.
Do you remember those days, though, when they set the Power Hour? They show you
don't
Hulk?
Know damn thing, but yeah.
Dude, so Channel 13, UPN.
Damn, what the fuck, UPN?
I remember that.
They had the Marvel Power Hour. They show you one episode of Incredible Hulk and one episode of Iron Man.
Damn.
And sometimes they would even fucking be in each other's shit.
Damn.
And you're like, damn, all hyped and shit.
That's cool.
Yeah, but I was really hoping Marvel would get like a TGIF thing going. Imagine if we had a block, WandaVision, Falcon, Winter Soldier, Loki, and fucking What If, like the four of them just mixed up coming.
Day, dude, that'd be too much.
I mean, it'll probably happen one day when they have more shows going on in the future. But for now, that's all with that. But.
Yeah. So you know what that means, though?
What's that?
Because Unfocused is filmed on Wednesdays, as you hear at the end of the episodes every time. That means we'll be able to watch it Tuesday midnight. Talk about it the next day on Wednesday.
That's kind of great.
Right?
I like that.
Because sometimes I forget what the fuck I watched, like, you know, 5 days later. It's like, oh, yeah, we did watch the last episode of Falcon, Winter Soldier. What the fuck happened again? That's usually me, though. But, yeah, so that was a cool little announcement that we got there.
Okay. All right, my turn?
Sure.
AJ.
Okay.
I have three words to ask you about. What do these three words mean to you? Threat level midnight.
Means one of the greatest movies within a TV show.
Right, exactly. One of the greatest movies never filmed, right?
Yeah.
Just like Jodorowsky's Dune.
This is in The Office, the character Michael Scott, the head manager at Dunder Mifflin Scranton branch. He's a bit of a character, and he's very super creative, and he likes to do his own shit and make his own thing, including making his own movie. And this is something that he wrote in an earlier episode, like in season 2 or 3. The office members end up coming across a script of Threat Level Midnight, like, and they go ahead and do a table read of it, and it's just kind of funny, right? Like, oh, this is funny. Later on, like in season like 7 or 8 or some shit, they actually show us bits of the movie in the episode, and I think this also exists on YouTube somewhere too, like the whole thing, the whole movie. What's new about this?
So, apparently, there will be a graphic novel being sold by this company called Dunder Mifflin Paper.
What the fuck?
And it's a real website. And this website is going to be selling. You can pre-order now if you want. It's currently hosting a sale on the pre-order, offering the book that they plan to retail at $40 for just $20. So if you pre-order it now, you get this comic book at $20. Instead of 40.
So some Dunder Mifflin comic?
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy.
That's funny.
And these guys will be putting out the comic book trade paperback called Threat Level Midnight.
That's crazy.
That's funny.
Yeah, it's gonna have the cover is gonna be somewhat of a parody of The Walking Dead #1.
Oh, is it?
With Dwight on the cover in the Rick Grimes role. It's gonna be as if Dwight was Rick Grimes, you know, like the main guy. But yeah, you're gonna be able to buy this comic if you really want to see the whole story of Threat Level Midnight.
Yeah, in a comic form. That sounds crazy.
Yeah, so, it's written, of course, written by Michael Scott, with an eye toward having him appear as the lead character, a thinly veiled self-insert character called Michael Scarn.
Yep.
This will be the main character of this comic book, yep. It's Michael Scarn.
As he should. I wonder if this would be the actual movie that we did see, where he had to say the president playing hockey, or if it's going to be like another side story, a side mission that he had.
I'm not sure about
that. Yeah, I don't know either.
Yeah, there's not much in the ways of detail. Here, this is just me reading straight off of it. Not much in the way of details about Threat Level Midnight, although it's likely to be done by Saldana and Nora Stepp. In 2019, the official YouTube page The Office released a version of Threat Level Midnight that isn't intercut with the plot elements of The Office show.
Yeah, that's the one I was talking about.
Okay,
right now.
Yeah,
that's on YouTube. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that sounds crazy. Who's actually making this comic? Because Dunder Mifflin Paper, that's the name of the company in the TV show.
Well, it's probably the company who makes The Office, because that's the name of the website. So I'm guessing
the
company that makes The Office must be doing that under a shadow.
Because I'm wondering, like, who's really doing this comic? Is it Dark Horse or Image or, you know, something like that?
Well, let's see.
DC.
The creator, Greg Daniels.
Greg Daniels, yeah.
Ask him about it, and he says he has yet to have big conversations with Peacock about this.
Oh, Peacock.
He hasn't talked to them about it. He said, I think that the talk really came up with when they did Will and Grace and they rebooted that show. But I don't think we would be able to get all the cast together to really make this into a live action. Oh, I guess this is a talk about them making this into a show.
Yeah.
And he hasn't got to talk to Peacock about this yet, apparently, except for this got his minimal support from their website.
Okay. Well, I guess we'll find out.
Yeah. Interesting shit. AJ, got some news for us?
Yeah. So Terry Crews, you know Terry Crews, right?
Yeah, that buff creepy guy.
He's not creepy. He's pretty cool. He's actually a bit of a nerd, too.
I heard he is, right?
Yeah, because I know one of the tech YouTube channels I follow that make computers and all that, Jay's 2 Cents, he actually built a computer for Terry Crews, and he had it be like Old Spice themed, because, you know, Terry Crews did a bunch of Old Spice commercials, too, right? So Terry Crews, he wanted a computer built so he can play, I think it was Overwatch, so he can stream Overwatch play and all that. So he plays games, you know? And he actually tweeted this out last week. Just one tweet in all caps saying, localized Mother 3.
Wow. He's fighting for fucking Mother now?
Yeah.
I love it.
That's all he says. Localized Mother 3. I'm pretty sure half the people that follow him didn't know what the fuck he's talking about.
Damn, bro. But that's, you know, that's the gamers a deep cut. That's a deep cut. Right? I like that.
Yeah. And then, like, I like the, some of the replies. You got, you know, Drake over here clapping at a basketball game, you know, clapping for Terry Crews. We got this freaking, what's his name? What's this dude's name? Lucas right here in flames. I don't know why. And these are just some of the responses that people, you know.
That's fucking funny. These people are all hyped. That's hilarious. Maximum Psy. I love it.
That's funny. Yeah. PSI. Psy. I get it. Anyways, yeah. So, I don't know. Pretty interesting that. That he's asking for it. I think the response was because Nintendo posted something or said something that talked about Mother 3 for some reason, and it kind of got around, and I guess everyone started complaining all over again, like, what the fuck, Mother 3? And he was just part of that crowd. It's like, localized Mother 3! So, I don't know, kind of crazy that he went out and did that.
He kept the wave going. Yeah. Yeah, I like it.
So, pretty interesting. Hopefully he could do something about it. We'll see.
All right, so lately Pepsi has been getting coming out with new flavors and stuff, like Pepsi Mango, Pepsi Mango Zero, which sounds whack. But you know,
so no mango, huh?
Now they've gone back on their releases, and they've re-released Pepsi Blue.
The sin.
Oh, you didn't like that one?
No.
For some reason, I thought you were the one that hated liked that it. Shit.
No,
okay.
I did not like it.
I didn't like it either. That shit was fucking weird. Like,
Pepsi Blue? Like?
Windex.
Really? It's like, no, it's like,
it might as
like
well
a,
be.
It's like a chemical fruity flavor. Like, it's, I mean, it's weird, bro. Like, it's not like it's bad. It's just
no, it
weird.
Was bad.
He says it's bad. Sure. People loved it, though. I mean, there was a lot of
I don't
people.
Know why people loved it. Like, people with no taste, I suppose.
I like Pepsi Lime, but.
That's fine.
That's not the same thing as this. This was like a concoction. Like, I can't even compare it to anything. It was almost like a Gatorade, but like soda. Sure. And it, I mean,
yeah,
I.
It's more like Windex with bubbles. Sure.
Yeah, like, you know what I mean?
You know who liked it? What's his name? Was it Vince? Remember Mark and
oh,
Seven
that's
Vince?
Who it was. Vince liked it. That's yeah. Right. He's like, bring back Pepsi Blue. He kept saying, yeah.
And I was like, no, dude.
I thought it was you. No, it's him. Okay, I remember now.
No, I mean, I love the color blue. I love weird shit. But
no,
not that weird.
No, because I remember I asked my mom to buy me
I did try it one
Pepsi
time.
Blue one time. Yeah. And I remember, like, I was like, oh, I'm excited to have it. And I was drinking it like I was excited. And then halfway through the bottle, like, I just wasn't drinking it.
I remember
I was carrying it around with me, you know, like not actually drinking it, but I still had it though. Like, oh, Pepsi Blue, but I wasn't drinking it. And I was like, oh man, I didn't know to myself that was a subconscious sign. It's not that good, bro. You don't like it.
I remember buying it and taking that first sip, and I was like, this is horrible. And I tried another sip, like maybe I'm just tasting shit. Like, no, this is bad. I don't even remember. I don't remember finishing it. I don't know what I did with it. I'm pretty sure I didn't finish it though.
Yeah. Well, apparently there's fiends for it, and it's bad.
Yeah, there is. I don't know why.
You can find it on shelves right now in some supermarkets and grocery stores.
Good. You think they improved the formula?
No, I feel like
no,
because
if they did, then people will complain.
Then people would bitch. Yeah, oh yeah, exactly. That's true. Then people would be all mad and shit. Like, oh, it's not the same one. You know, there'd be the one jackass who would taste it, and on first taste, he'd be like, nope,
not it.
That's not it. Like, it's just like You know, I work at a place where, like, there's fine wine and shit. But, no, you know, nobody's really that good at wine. You know, just, like, people just like to try it out and, like, taste it and shit. I remember they had this one motherfucker. He just fucking, I poured him his taster. This motherfucker smelled it, and he said, it's corked. And I was like,
dude.
What? All of us were like, what? And then, like, we gave it back to our bartender. You know, he tasted it. He's like, he's right. And we were like, whoa. I feel like that's probably what happened. Like, somebody with a Pepsi Blue fan would have been like, we wouldn't even taste it. You're like, it's wrong. Like, no, take it back. You know, so.
The formula's been changed.
Yeah, someone fucked with it. They changed this chemical.
it's no longer corn syrup.
Yeah, right?
This is real sugar.
It's plus corn syrup. But it's not the same thing.
It's not the right flour.
If you are a nerd about Pepsi Blue, it is back, and you can find it in big-ass retail stores. You will not find it in your local stores. You will not find it in little gas stations, unless you're going to, like, fucking, what, 76 or Chevron.
I don't know.
But, you know, man, if it's not a big-ass company, you're not going to get this shit in there. Like, it's a big release thing, so. AJ?
And then while you're drinking your Pepsi Blue, I hope you're choking that shit.
Damn. 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 Damn.
So.
Wait, do we have a roundup this week?
Oh, we do actually have a toy roundup right, this week.
Why don't you do one more, and then I'll do one more, and then we'll do a toy roundup.
All right. So, For the last couple of weeks and shit, we've been talking about Discord. You know, there's a whole story about Microsoft might buy them. They're in talks right now for billions of dollars. And then there was a news, I think it was last week, saying like, hey, you know what? Microsoft and Discord not talking anymore. It fell through. It's not going to happen.
We talked about it last week. Yeah.
Well, more news came out. Looks like Sony has gone ahead and taken an interest in Discord and, you know, gave them some money. Not to take it, you know, just to have an investment in Discord. So they're not buying Discord, but they are collaborating now, and they're going to try to integrate Discord into PlayStation in some way now. We're not going to see it this year, but they say by next year, we should see some type of integration with Discord and PlayStation.
Discord and PlayStation. You know, if anyone's going to have Discord, I think PlayStation would probably be the better company for them, you know?
You think so? I don't know.
What do you think? How do you feel about Sony's online chats and stuff like that?
I fucking don't know, because I've not had a Sony system in years, so
to be honest, when I use the Xbox app to chat with whoever's on Xbox, that app is horrible. That's why I'm happy that Discord exists, you know, so...
You heard it here first from DJ.
Yeah.
Resident actual console gamer. So, yeah,
we still exist.
Yeah, like I mean I just use PC now, so like I have Discord just open now, and now if I'm playing games I need to chat with anybody, so it's like it's not too big of a deal for me. But I don't know, I'd rather actually had Microsoft actually buy Discord, because Microsoft Windows PC, I'm using PC, so I would have been okay with that. And Microsoft is trying to branch out and get their games in other places now, and there's rumors that Microsoft wants to put like their Xbox Live, or what's it called, Xbox Game Pass, they want to have it on other systems, so you know, you can download this, you know, app for Xbox on your PlayStation, on your Switch, and be able to play Xbox games on those consoles. They kind of want to do that, supposedly. So having Discord integrated in that would make sense for them. Sony, I don't know, because Sony, I don't know, we had to fucking choke them to death to fucking give us crossplay with other systems, right? So
yeah, everything had to go against them for them to do that.
Yeah, so pretty nice. But this is only an investment, and like they're not like you know buying it out. So it's just a partnership. That's all it is right now. Also, I'm wondering too if this has anything to do with Evo, because Sony owns a part of Evo now, right?
Yeah, so they own a big part of it.
Yeah, so I wonder if that has to do anything with this too. Maybe they're getting Discord because Evo's about to be online later this year. Yeah. Maybe they'll do some integrations there where we have to go log into Discord so we can check into our pools and all that, which most tournaments nowadays do anyways. So maybe that's going to be a thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
But that's kind of my feels with it. It's like, all right, it's cool. They don't own it, so I'm not too mad.
Okay, so there's a recent interview with an interviewer called Fast Company. And they interviewed Nintendo's new head of Nintendo Movie Studios.
It's called Fast Company?
That's the name of the company that did the interview. Yeah, that did the company.
Did they do it fast?
The company did the interview. I don't know if it was actually fast.
Ah, okay.
But moral of the story is, they did an interview with Nintendo's new head of movie and films director. You know, like, you know, they have somebody for every part of Nintendo, like America, Japan, you know, all the shit they do.
Right.
They have a movie head. His name is Shuntaro Furukawa. And they had an interview with him. And they said their company plans to do more movies after the Mario Brothers movie, which is going to be the animated CGI one that's coming soon.
Right.
So they're saying that Mario is not it. After Mario's done, they will go through their library and continue to make Nintendo movies based off of their core franchise things, which hopefully means Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong?
I would watch
Legend of Zelda?
I'm not going to say anything about that. I'm not going to think about that, because I don't want to be fucking disappointed when it doesn't happen. So I'm just going to imagine that's not going to happen. I'd watch a Captain Olimar movie.
What is it?
I'd watch a Captain Olimar movie. Yeah. I'd watch a Pikmin movie.
Freaking F-Zero?
Yo, F-Zero movie would be dope. And so moral of the story, so you brought me to my point of bringing up this article. Is he hinting at them doing a Marvel Cinematic Universe movie? Like the franchise where eventually it culminates... And Smash Brothers.
Like, we just have separate movies?
Yeah. And something like, and eventually, like, they just, like...
So, they just combine just to fight each other?
Well, you know, like, maybe they won't even make a
thing.
They
gotta fight Master Hand.
Maybe they'll each
have... There's a storyline in Smash Bros.
I was like, maybe they'll each have their own shit totally unconnected. You know, you're watching it, blah, blah, blah. And then one of those movies has an end credits scene where you fucking see Donkey Kong there with Link, like, what the fuck are you doing
here? No, dude.
A big hand for
no.
Or a big hand comes out, or maybe just that, like a big hand comes out.
This is what happens. So it's like the end of F-Zero, right? You have this whole racing thing. You've forgotten about Mario. You've forgotten all that, right? And then end credit scene, right, happens. You see Mario, like, oh, Mario, that's cool. And then all of a sudden he opens his mailbox and there's an envelope with the Smash logo on it. And then he skipped to Donkey Kong. Same shit, you know? Mailbox opened up, damn. Smash logo, you know?
So like the end of the Captain America movie, right? Remember the end of the Captain America movie? They had like a little quick promo for Avengers and they showed
it. Oh, yeah, yeah.
It'd be like that, right?
Yeah, like, something like that, yeah. Damn. Everyone was just pulling out like an envelope.
The invitation and shit? Damn. Dude, I got one for you. You see a hand writing a letter, and it says, Smash Brothers attendance, you have been sent this letter because you are chosen for this combat. And it zooms out, and you see the hand has no arm.
Yeah, that would be sick.
Master hands.
No, rather him than writing the letter, though, actually just so the hand is kind of from a distance writing something, but you can't see it, and then it folds it into the envelope, and then it does the fucking wax stamp. With the Smash logo on it, and that's when it fades away. And you see just the floating hands right there,
or you know,
and you see the crazy hand in the background, just like
right. Oh, I was gonna say, maybe the crazy hand seals it. You know, they stab it in the crazy hand, bam, 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 like seal. But yeah, anyways, it's very interesting that this guy went out of his way to say that, you know, Mario's not the end. We're planning to do multiple franchises of...
In this movie, is it already available?
No, it's not available yet.
None of this is available yet.
We haven't even seen a trailer yet of the Super Mario Brothers movie. I think it's supposed to appear next year, the beginning of next year.
Okay.
Which means we'll probably get a trailer summer, fall, one of the two.
Yeah, later this year.
But it's going to be a totally CGI, totally animated Mario Brothers movie. They haven't said what the plot's going to be, but they did say it's going to be Mario and Luigi just doing Mario Brothers shit. CGI, that's all we know.
And then does that mean we can expect, like, you know, 20 Fire Emblem movies?
Oh, shit. How about Fast and Furious 9?
Fire Emblem 20.
Fire Emblem 9, yeah. Oh, man, no. I hope not, dude. Okay. But, yeah, that being said, let's jump into the toy roundup. Wags, what you got for us,
Wags,
man?
Wags is back.
What's up, Wags?
I don't know what Wags is. Actually, I do know what Wags is because I have to edit this whole thing today.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to another toy news roundup. It is currently 5 a.m. This is actually the only time I could do this video as I am crazy busy.
I can hear you, yeah.
So, yeah, this is my morning hair. This is mine. I just woke up here. Hey, Grimlock. Of course you're here.
Yes. So don't say too much.
Last time we did this, we talked about the Hasbro Pulse Fan Fest, and we talked about Transformers specifically. We didn't talk about Star Wars or G.I. Joe's. I don't think we're going to have time to talk about that today either. We will talk about the Power Rangers, though, that they revealed. So at this point in time, they've actually released all the Mighty Morphin Power Ranger figures, with the last one being the Black Ranger. Last year's Power Ranger Comic-Con exclusive was a metallic version of the Pink Ranger, but instead of the Kimberly head, she was using the, I forget her name, I think it's Kat or Caitlin or something
it's
like that.
Kat.
The blonde girl.
Kat.
That I didn't really like. It was very robotic.
Nope, nobody really liked her.
They used her head sculpt.
She was kind of a bitch. Huh?
Anyways, surprisingly, it's still available, even though it's a year later and it was a Comic-Con exclusive. So you can still pick that up if you want. So for the Hasbro Pulse Fan Fest, they actually revealed the rest of the team as metallic versions. And if you remember from the show, the metallic costumes were something they did for like 3 or 4 episodes. It was very short.
So,
and actually all these Power Rangers, all these metallic versions of the Power Rangers, used head sculpts for the cast that was introduced later on in the series. When the original cast asked for more money, and they're like, no, screw you, get the fuck out, we'll hire cheaper actors.
That's so fucked up.
So the lineup is as such. So they have, for the metallic Blue Ranger, it's older Billy without his glasses. For the Yellow Ranger, it's Aisha. The Black Ranger is Vash the Stampede. And the metallic Red Ranger is Jason number 2.
Rocky.
So now you can complete your collection of metallic Power Rangers. I have actually already ordered the metallic Black Ranger. $24.99, still available pre-order, not sold out.
Cool.
So in the midst of the Hasbro Pulse Fan Fest, Diamond Select did their own little, I guess, fan fest type thing. They did a live stream that I don't think anybody watched, where they revealed a bunch of their own new stuff. Here's some highlights from that. So we already know that Avatar has a Toph, Violet Ozai, Sokka, and Avatar Aang Final Battle. So that's nothing new. And then they showed off their Lord of the Rings stuff, which is stuff that we already knew. But they revealed two new figures.
I couldn't find pictures.
Which you need in order to finish making Sauron, Gandalf, and Gollum. Look pretty good. And Gandalf's huge, but look at Gollum. He's so tiny. And they're the same price. I hope Gollum comes with a ton of accessories to make up for that. Now, this is new. So they have a Cobra Kai line now. It's got John Kreese, Johnny Lawrence, and Daniel LaRusso. And the only one that actually looks like the character actor is John Kreese. The other two look a little...
Oh, yeah, he's right. He does look right.
Look a lot off. Invader Zim again.
Oh, that's cool.
What's interesting about this version of the Invader Zim figures is they have different head sculpts from what they've been advertising in their promo pics. So I don't know if it's an alternate head that comes with the set, which wasn't included in their list of accessories, or if it's like a variant version, which you can get depending on the retailer. I don't know. It's very weird. And then the last thing that the Diamond Select revealed was another version of their Tron figures.
What?
This was intended to be their Comic-Con exclusive for this year, but no Comic-Con, so... So we've seen these molds before. This is actually the fourth time for two of these molds. And the fifth time for the Tron mold itself. And these are done up to look like the original action figures that released with the movie. You know, those really simple five-jointed
looks
figures.
Looks like he has a...
Same style.
Candy stick in his hand.
They look good. I really like the way they look. $80 this summer. I can't believe that they just
for all three. I hope
any actually new molds. There's so many figures that they still need to make to complete the movie line, and they just keep using the same three over and over again. That purple looks sweet. And then one of the last things that we'll talk about. This wasn't a Hasbro Pulse Fan Fest thing. But this is still really cool. Marvel Legends has revealed another new wave, and oh my gosh, I might buy this entire wave. I might actually buy a case of this. This is their Disney Plus wave. So this is based off characters from their Disney Plus
TV series. Oh, that's dope. Disney Plus wave?
It's a total of 7 waves, and we'll get to the Build-A-Figure last. Some of these figures have been revealed already in the past. We talked about them. Baron Zemo is one we talked about with the amazing head sculpt. A White Vision is in this wave as well. Scarlet Witch WandaVision is in this wave, which is interesting because when it was revealed, indicated by sources to be a Walmart exclusive. So it looks like that's not true. Thank goodness. You may actually be able to get this. So 4 new characters are part of this wave. Bucky from the Winter Soldier Falcon series.
With his arm.
Loki from the Loki series, which I have to say doesn't look very good. I don't like what they did with his hair.
Yeah, he doesn't.
The windswept look is not working for him. He comes with no accessories, no extra hands, nothing to... Like, he doesn't even have his crown. What the heck? Where's his crown? A U.S. agent, not Captain America. U.S. agent. And he actually doesn't even come with a shield, which is true because he was in the show for like 2 seconds and... Came out with nothing. I don't
think
he has
Falcon's wing.
Listen,
but he does look really
from
cool.
Where he rips off his wing?
No, watch. He'll tell you
US
what it is.
U.S. agent. I didn't really want Captain America, but U.S. agent looks fantastic. I mean, I didn't want the John Walker Captain America. And the last figure is obviously Sam Wilson's Captain America, and it looks fantastic. I need to get this. The one cool thing that it's hard to see is that his glasses are actually transparent, and you can see his eyes through it. So they actually sculpted and painted eyes underneath that, which is freaking awesome. He doesn't come with extra hands. He just comes with a shield. He doesn't come with wings. You know why he doesn't come with wings? Because that's the Build-A-Figure. You have to buy all 7 of these figures if you want to build his wings.
Sure.
Motherfucker.
Get the little robot
but the wings do look sweet, though. They're very
Fuck. Red wing.
Another added piece.
Dick move, Marvel.
Is in the show. Oh, man. By the way, these are all spoilers. In case you didn't know. The wings have a part in the back, a peg hole, actually, to insert Captain America's shield into it. Like in the show, when he's flying, you see it kind of hanging back there. but the shield that he comes with cannot peg into his backpack. Only one shield can. So if you want to have that look from the series where he's flying with the shield in the back, you actually have to buy an entirely separate figure that is not part of this wave. The Walmart exclusive John Walker Captain America that we talked about, his shield is the one that can peg into his back.
No!
If you really want to complete the Captain America Sam Wilson figure, you
need... Fucking dick move. Oh my God.
One more Marvel Legends figures that was revealed that's not part of this wave.
You're probably pissed, dude.
It's like an online retailer exclusive. It's part of the Infinity Saga, which we know that Thor was part of. Quicksilver from Avengers 2, the one who died. He's getting his own figure. He's a little pricey, though.
He looks so regular, he's pricey.
Like $27 for him, which is crazy, because Marvel Legends are normally like $20. So I don't know why he's... I don't know why they're asking for so much for this. And he does come with alternate hands. No alternate torso with bullet wounds, sadly, so...
Wow.
And that's about all the time that we have, and hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope I didn't sound too sleepy. And thanks for watching. Back to you guys. Take care.
Thank you, Wags. That being said, I guess we should... Oh, man, that's fucking hilarious.
I think I edited that video pretty good, because he has a
lot... Oh, you were the editor? That was good.
Because he rambles on about random shit sometimes, and so I made sure to calm him down a little bit.
Good job. Whenever he puts his own channel out and fucking gets viral, he needs to get you to be his editor, because that was good. I liked it a lot. Okay. That being said, man, I can't believe... It's not enough to have the fucking all the figures. You have to get that exclusive John Walker.
Yeah.
That shield goes on the Falcon.
And it's the John Walker Captain America. Not the John Walker U.S. agent. It's the Captain America John Walker.
It literally follows the plot line of the fucking show. Right? You have to follow the plot line of the show.
Waste all that money.
Yeah, exactly. And you gotta get the Walmart exclusive. Like, man.
Yeah.
I think I might get Justice Scarlet Witch.
I don't know if I should be angry or impressed with right. The way they did that whole toy thing. You know, I'm kind of impressed that like, you got to watch the show to know that John Walker gets the shield from John Walker.
Marvel and Disney are already rich. Why are they making it so hard? You know,
man,
because they're rich enough to do so.
They could still
that's what the rich do, man. Because
they could still be richer, Danny. Yeah. That's the problem.
Yeah, they don't have all the money
rich
yet.
Rich get richer, the poor get poorer.
You know, man, you don't get it, Danny.
It's business, Danny.
It's your fault because you don't get it. You know? Okay, that being said, let's jump into my favorite segment.
Okay!
No.
Oh.
Wait, stop. This isn't the segment we're jumping into. My other segment, please.
Oh, your segment? Should we play the whole thing?
Nah. Can't
stop it. How do I stop it? Okay.
Okay, moral of the story, we're on my personal segment about dick moves. People doing... shithead moves against nerds.
Just
mainly
like,
it's about, yeah, the companies.
Just like the one you just saw.
Yeah, mainly about companies fucking over nerds. So DJ, I want to get your input on this, man. You ready?
All right, go for it.
Two things I'm mad about from DC right now.
Okay.
I hate to be talking shit about DC.
That's all good.
The only reason I hate it is because Marvel just fucking put out that trailer, and I was already like, damn, DC can't really fuck with them right now. And then this is their response move. So check this out, Danny. Today they announced... One, the Black Superman movie they're trying to make, he's not going to be the Black Kryptonian. He will be Kal-El.
The father?
No, Kal-El. Clark Kent.
Okay.
So basically, they're just going to make a Superman movie, but black.
So Superman, a black guy.
Yeah.
So not someone else from the planet
who
happens to be black.
Which is a character, by the way. There is a black Kryptonian that survives. It has a really cool character, cool arc, and he takes over Superman's job for a little while. Would have been a great movie, right? No. They're going to make Kal-El, you know, Clark Kent, black. Just because. Why not?
But Clark Kent's such a white... A white name?
Right?
He's grew up in Kansas! I'm like, why are we doing this? And, you know, I always talk about, I want more black people in fucking superhero movies. For sure, I want more black representation. But don't fuck with Superman, bro. He's already the guy. We know who he is. And I'm like, ugh. So DC just said, because this was a rumor months ago. that, you know, DC doesn't want to do more Henry Cavill movies. They want to make the Black Superman movies. And then
they can remake Steel.
Right? There's options. There's options. Robot Steel, like. Dude, there's Steel. There's like so many characters. Black Lightning. There's so many characters you could do that are actual black characters you could make. But no, we're going to make, even, like I said, even a Kryptonian who's black. But no, we're going to make Superman black. I'm like, fuck. So that's dick move number one today. Dick move number two. DC says they're going forward with a Joker 2.
The movie? The one that we saw with
Joaquin Phoenix?
With Joaquin Phoenix. And the only reason this is a problem is because both the creator of the first Joker movie and Joaquin Phoenix were very clear there doesn't need to be any more.
That's true.
It's very complete. It's done. It tells the story we wanted to tell. It's a parallel universe anyway, so it's done.
It doesn't matter.
But DC just said, no.
We want money.
We're making more. Yeah, sorry. It's happening. Ignore what the creator said. Fuck him. Ignore the lead actor who's in it. Fuck him. We're saying we're making more, and that's what's happening. And like, DC, no!
Most people that like the Harley Quinn movies are the ones that are going to watch all the, what you just mentioned.
Oh, I know, bro. Like, I mean, I didn't think Birds of Prey was the worst, but it was just, I felt like they were also trying to shove shit down my throat.
No, yeah, they were milking, don't milking the damn cow.
Yeah, bro. You say that
expression, you know.
No, you're right. Yeah,
and I was that's why I didn't see those movies, because I knew exactly what they were doing. That's why I don't know if I want to see Suicide Squad.
No, that one you should watch. That's James Gunn, bro. You need to watch that movie. That's fucking James Gunn, dude.
I do trust you, so.
Dude, James, I feel you on, I like Birds of Prey, but I don't think you need to watch it, because I agree with you. They're milking the cow. But Suicide Squad 2? No, bro. That's James Gunn. They gave him freedom to do whatever he wants with the story, and he made me care about Guardians of the Galaxy. It's got to be at least okay.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
At least okay, you know? But no, man, I'm like, DC, bro, they're zigging where they're supposed to zag. Like, Marvel just came out with that dope-ass trailer with all these cool things they're about to do. And DC says, we're going to go forward with Joker 2 and Black Superman. And then all the fucking, right now, DC fans are like, what? Like,
this is their chance to revamp Green Lantern with, you know, what was his name? The Green Lantern?
Yeah, with Jon Stewart.
Jon Stewart, there you go.
Could have done that.
Could have done that too, you know.
Yeah, Steel, Jon Stewart, they're like,
they're going to brought back Green Lantern. With that guy.
Yeah, if you want to take advantage of black characters right now, like, just pick the ones that are actually black. Don't try to make other characters black. I was like, yes, Chibi Wags, there are black Kryptonians. As we were mentioning, there is a man who is a surprise survivor from Krypton that takes over Superman's mantle when people think he's dead at one point in the more modern, I think it's in the New 52s. And, you know, he's a pretty cool character. He's okay. You know, he's cool. He does his thing. You know, he keeps the mantle in place. But it's like, you don't have to make... I don't want Clark Kent to be black. Why?
Do you think DC is stupid and they're watching the Marvel shit right now? Falcon, Winter Soldier. And they're like, whoa, they just made Captain America black. Why can't they just do that to click? You know, like...
Yeah, AJ, that's exactly why this is in my dick move segment. Because I think that's exactly what's happening. They're watching these Marvel things and they're not really learning the lessons that Marvel's trying to tell them.
That was in the comics.
Exactly. But I don't think...
Black Superman, I never seen in a comic.
I don't think DC knows that. I think DC was just like watching the show, like, oh, that's cool. This is freaking, we replace Steve Rogers with this black dude. It's a new Steve Rogers, you know?
I think it might even be worse than that. I think they might be so obsessed with the competition that it's getting lost in the story. Like, I don't know if you guys remember. Oh, go ahead. What did you say?
Well, even in Fantastic Four, the last one that came out, when they made the Human Torch black, I didn't have a problem with that.
That was fine. I was cool with that. Whatever, you know, whatever.
It's just that, like, they're picking, I don't know.
I agree
with you. Like, why?
Like, why?
You could do something else.
Yeah, there's so many things that could be done with that. And I agree with you, because, like, for some reason, making the Human Torch black wasn't a big deal. I agree. Like, it's not a big deal, because, like, he's a character that's not, like, super iconic. Mm-hmm. Superman looks a certain way. It's just like if you were to make fucking Jon Stewart a white guy. Like, why? I know what Jon Stewart looks like. You know, like, this is him.
It's like if Marvel decided to make Black Panther a white dude. You know, I'm saying.
And call him Pink Panther.
That's a
Pink Panther. He's a detective.
DJ, you're right. That's a better comparison than what I said. It's like if they decided to make Black Panther a white dude.
And which everyone would have been fucking crazy over, too, but that's it's going the wrong way.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. So I'm like, I'm really mad at them because they just, I feel like no matter, every time, the more movies they make, the more clear it is that they don't get it. Like, that they're not listening to their fans, and they don't really know what people want to see.
These are the same people that are getting paid bank for their ideas.
Bank, bro!
We have better ideas, and yet, we're here.
Yeah. That's probably the problem, too, which, like, a lot of people say is a big problem in most big companies, is that it's just a bunch of old people, like, in a room trying to, like, just find ways to make money, and they're not really, like, you know, looking at the overall picture, like, oh, let's just do this again, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do this now, you know? But, like, they're not really going back, like, oh, we can just recycle this and continue this thing and make this better, or let's dig back into our crates and pull out some old things and bring that back. No, they just start creating new shit, like, thinking it's the answer.
Yes, sir.
When really that's not what it is.
That's good.
Like, yeah, some people eat it up because maybe they're stupid and don't know what's going on, and they think
they don't, or they don't care.
Or they don't care. Maybe they think they're going to do the right thing this time, and they end up not doing it. So I think that's going on with DC right now. And they need to find their own, like, Kevin Feige, who's actually in tune with the fans and with the content that exists already that they can pull from. If anything, it might be an easier job to go back to old content and pull shit out of there rather than make brand new stuff that upsets people.
Dude,
or retell the same story already told 1,000 times.
100%. Mortal Kombat made it clear that making a brand new story is harder. It's fucking harder. Just use what you have, you know? Like, oh, I didn't tell you. So there's an interview with the guy who wrote the script for Mortal Kombat. And, you know, everyone, you know, we were even talking about it last week. What's up with Cole? You know, what's up with Cole Young? Like, why did you do that? And so when you see his interview with Variety, he only says it very quickly, and he only says it once.
Cole was a mistake. By the way, it was a great movie.
No, but it was like that. He says, Cole was a studio decision.
Okay, yeah.
But then he only says it the one time. He glazes over it and keeps going, keeps talking about it like it wasn't a big deal. Because I think he would get in trouble if he made it super clear he didn't make that choice.
Yeah.
The studio told him they have to do that.
Yeah.
But he said, you know, we all thought about it, what made most sense, but at the end of the day, it was a studio decision. But, you know, we still wrote these things, and this made sense to us, and blah, blah. He kept excusing it, but it was a studio decision.
Okay, then. Well,
because the studio felt that we needed a window into Mortal Kombat, and which is, you know, the same problem with all the 90s superhero movies and comic movies and video game movies. The studio decides that they know what you want, you know, like, and just like you're saying.
Or they think you need help understanding the story, so let's give you this character you can relate to.
Yeah.
So you can understand his universe.
Wild.
Man. Yeah. It's insane. I feel like that's what happened to a lot of our old TV shows, like that Night Warriors, Darkstalkers. There's a random kid in there who, like, works with them, you know?
Yeah, I know. I'm like, what's this all about?
They done some other shit like that in the past, too, and other cartoon shows. Like, why is this extra character in here? We don't need this character.
Yeah, it doesn't help the story.
Studios and just higher-ups just think we need it.
Yeah.
Anyways.
All right, AJ?
Speaking of movies and studio decisions, Detective Pikachu.
What about it?
Would you like a sequel?
Yeah,
well, too bad. You're not getting one.
Shit.
Oh, for real?
So we're not getting the Pink Panther with?
No Pink Panther.
Wait, are you serious?
So they're talking to Justin Smith, Justice Smith, the main lead, you know, in the movie, and he was saying that they want it to happen, but he was saying, like, pretty much it just doesn't look like it's gonna happen. He would love to participate in Detective 2. I don't know if it's going to happen, he says. I think we have to just kind of bury our hopes, he says. I don't think it's going to happen. Because I really hope it's. I really hope so, though. Honestly, I'm such a huge fan. Who knows? I hope so. That's all he says.
I guess these people don't want money.
That's what it's starting to feel like, huh? Like they don't want money.
Like to see, they don't want money either.
So I guess he's pretty much saying, like, yeah, there's no talks about it. It may not even happen. Who knows? He would like it to happen, but doesn't look like it's going to happen. So, all right. So, I mean, that's fine because, like, is there another story? Because this was based off a video game, actually. There is actually a game called Detective Pikachu that this movie was based off of. I don't think we have anything else like that. You know, oh, imagine, though, they're going to wait for Pokemon, what's it called? Legends? Arceus? And maybe they make a movie out of that? That would be sick.
Hey, that'd be cool.
We'll see, though. I don't know. But, yeah, as of now, no news on getting a new Detective Pikachu, or maybe hopefully something in that universe would be cool, but so far, nothing.
Okay.
Oh, we got like two stories left.
All right. You got two? Okay, I think I got two. All right, so earlier this week, Roku had issued a warning. Roku had issued a warning for subscribers to stop using YouTube TV. I don't know why this is happening. But now, officially... Wait. I'll tell more, and then you give me the description. So, but it's because... and now Roku has officially stopped allowing new subscribers to download YouTube Red and YouTube TV. You can't get it. Now, if you already have it on your unit... On your Roku, you can still access it and use it. But until there is some kind of deal met with Google... Yep. Apparently, this will not be a thing. Mm-hmm. Now, AJ, give me some context, man. What the fuck?
It's pretty much what you just said right there. Like, YouTube and Roku trying to make a deal. I guess Roku wants a little bit of YouTube's share over there, and YouTube's like, nah, fuck y'all. Just give what you have. So, like, the contract's up, you know, and they're renegotiating, and they couldn't come to any terms. And so, because the contract's pretty much up at this point, those apps are off of Roku now. So, if you already have it, you're cool. But if you never downloaded it into your Roku system, you won't be able to find it because they're not talking to each other right now.
Yeah, they're not on speaking terms right now. Yeah.
So that's what's going on. Is this pretty much them just trying to make some type of contract happen?
And, by applying pressure.
Yeah, exactly. That's pretty much all it is. So that's what's going on
with
that.
That's kind of fucked, man.
Yeah. That's what happens with some of these devices too. Like, they gotta make deals and contracts with these other companies. You can't just put, you know, Peacock on a system and just expect it to be there. No, whoever owns that system, that TV, that box needs to negotiate with them and be like, "Yo, is this cool? And how are we gonna share this? Are we gonna share that? What's the deal?" And then don't make deals and stuff like that. So that has to happen.
That makes sense.
And then YouTube's not playing ball right now.
So sad. All right. Other quick piece of news. John Paul Leon died this week. He's a famous comic book artist for both Marvel and DC. A few things he's done. He's both done Ecstatic and Earth X. If anyone's ever read Earth X, it's a very super dark Marvel story about their fucked up future. But the artwork is kind of cartoony, but still cool looking. And he's really good at that super blotchy, dark lined, like cartoony look to his shit. Like, so very sad day. He's no longer going to be making art because he's passed away. But, rest in peace, John Paul Leon. I think he's like 50 or 60.
Oh, wow.
He's
so not even that old.
He's not that old, yeah, so it's kind of sad, but, you know. But yeah, so don't forget about him.
Yeah, some chat. You again or me again?
I think I said two. Yeah, your turn. You go for it.
Pokemon! Danny, this has kind of got the story for you here.
Cool.
We're getting there's a new expansion set for the trading card game in Pokemon. It's called Eevee Heroes. So it looks like this is going to focus on evolutions. They're saying within this expansion set, you'll be able to find V versions of all the evolutions. Vaporeon, Flareon, Jolteon, Espeon, Umbreon, Sylveon, Leafeon, Glaceon.
Who? They should release a new Eevee.
Like a new Eevee?
That'd be nice if they release it with this expansion. Like it's a secret.
Give us a new Eevee, like all of a sudden like in a trading card game? That'd be cool.
There's so many, though, don't you think?
I mean, there's not rock type.
Finish the set.
You know? Yeah, might as well finish all the elements.
Yeah.
Facts. Okay, you didn't go all the way, right? You're right.
Yeah,
you're
right. But there's VMAX versions of all of them that exist in this, so I guess those would be the Chinese to look out for. Also, apparently there's going to be some other regular versions of Eevee, also of Entei, Electrode, Florges, Grimmsnarl, and Marshadow. Oh, cool. Now, that Entei part, though, has me a little thinking here. So there's this old theory out there that exists saying that in Pokemon Gold and Silver, remember how you go to that burn tower and that's where the legendary dogs are at? Entei, Suicune, and Raikou. Supposedly the theory is that evolutions died in that tower.
Yeah, I heard that
and
story.
And then Ho-Oh rebirthed them and that's how they became legendary dogs. So seeing an Entei...
Wait, what? They're like super Eevees?
Yeah. So that's just a myth. It's never said in the game. That's what people just expect. Just because you find, because in that town, like there's a whole Eevee like gym over there, right? And in that tower. Oh, the other thing too was that their shiny version, even their color schemes, match like the legendary dogs to the original evolutions. Their color schemes, even their shinies, are like very similar. And the dogs, the legendary beasts, their hidden abilities or their dream world abilities match those of the evolutions' hidden abilities. So everyone's like, there's a connection here. Like, what are you not telling us? So seeing an Entei in this set for this Eevee set is kind of gives me like, are you trying to tell us something here, Pokemon? I don't know. I'm just saying. I just wanted to throw out that too.
I didn't hear that story too.
Yeah. I think I posted that on our Instagram, Unfocused28. I think I posted that story over there one time too. But that's my news on that.
Okay, the Pokemon Company and the Wand Company are doing a cross, which I think we've covered this a little bit before, but they've done their third replica in their series. I believe they've done the Pokeball and they've done the Master Ball. And now they've done the Great Ball. So this is a die-cast, hard fucking metal Great Ball that you can buy. And it features a metal shell with proximity touch that makes it activate and light up with LEDs like right before you touch it and right when you pick it up. I think we covered the Master Ball like maybe a month ago that they have done.
Maybe, I don't know.
I'm pretty sure we did. When pressed, the button will launch a Pokemon catching illumination sequence. The presentation case also includes an individually numbered hologram. It even lifts the replica for display when opened. So yeah, it's a cool little interactive fucking die-cast Pokeball, but a great ball.
Yeah.
Blue and purple, everything.
Wake me when they have a Dusk Ball.
If you want to get on, well, I think that's probably coming eventually.
I hope so.
Now that they went Pokeball, Master Ball, Great Ball. So I'm assuming maybe Ultra Ball next, and then maybe they'll go to Dusk Ball and the Net Ball.
Premier Ball. That's probably the next one, honestly.
Yeah, that would be the next one, wouldn't it?
It's a damn shame.
You can order this Great Ball right now on Sideshow Collectibles for $100. You can also pre-order it for $138 on Zavvi UK. And you'll get a Pokemon shirt to come with it.
Ooh.
But that's, you know, $38 extra for a shirt. Wow. So it depends on if it's good enough.
Oh, I was supposed
to. You can see how the replica works in the video that features as a video for this. Yeah, you guys can look it up and see how this thing looks.
It's cool. Pretty cool looking. Aren't they sold out? Says Dip. I don't know.
I didn't look
at it. I wouldn't doubt it, honestly.
I don't know if they're sold out. I just looked into that it exists. All right, AJ.
All right, well, my last story here is about esports. Apparently, there's an esports gym opening up in Tokyo. So, if you're interested, booking a 3-hour session and going to, this type of gym area where you can learn esports games, mainly focusing on like Valorant and League of Legends, then go to Tokyo. There you can find a coach. You can pay a coach to actually teach you how to play these games and all that. So it's actually like a gym, but for esports. Gamers can book a 3-hour time slot at one of the PCs for about $13 or opt for a monthly membership starting at $50, which allows daily access to the gaming PCs as well as optional coaching sessions that can be added for about $25 an hour. So yeah, if you want to get badass at certain PC games, apparently, go check out this esports gym in Tokyo.
All right. AJ, if you want to bring up a video for me, there was a trailer released today. These are my last two pieces of news. One is there was a trailer today for something that we've talked about previous episodes. The Paramount Plus is going to be doing a rollout of a lot of their IPs that they have under their label. And they're going to be making new content for all these IPs that they have, including Avatar The Last Airbender and specifically Rugrats.
Mm.
And now there's a trailer for the new reboot for Rugrats. Looks pretty good. CGI reboot, details all over shit. There. You can check it out there. We're going to show a little clip here. And I'm excited. I think it looks pretty cool. It starts pretty soon, May 27th. Which, you know, also, we never checked out those Avatar YouTube
videos. Yeah, I know. Thinking about that today, too.
I was thinking about it, too. We're fucking up. I like how you see Angelica's little doll on the side. You know the. Yeah.
Oh, it looks like they're not starting from scratch. Looks like they have Kimmy in here.
Yeah, they're gonna go from like the middle of it where everyone's established.
Yeah, I wonder if they're gonna retell some of the old like episodes. Actually, I thought I saw Kimmy in here. I guess not.
No, I saw her. She was there.
Yeah, okay, then I'm not tripping. Susie seems to be more involved. That's cool.
What the heck is happening? New Rugrats. I'm excited. I'm interested. I want to know what's up. I like the CGI look. Wags, don't hate.
Yeah, it looks all right. I'm not mad at it.
I like it. It looks good to me.
Yeah, I'm not mad at it at all.
All right. Yes, so keep an eye out for that, guys. Other things real quick. Ben Whitrock has been cast as Guy Gardner for this new Green Lantern series. It's going to be coming out on HBO Max for the DC Universe. This is going to be connected to Stargirl, Titans, and Doom Patrol. And, yeah, I just love that Guy Gardner's cast as a smart-ass, cool actor. This is a good choice for him. So, that is happening. And I feel like there's one last thing I want to talk about, but for Star Wars Day, may the Force be with you, yesterday, Disney had put out a Star Wars x Simpsons crossover. So there's a little Simpsons Star Wars crossover on Disney Plus if you want to check it out.
Is that one that already existed?
Nope, it's a new one.
That's never happened before?
Yeah, I don't know if it's never happened, but there's one that just came out, so.
Did they recast the or reshow the robot chicken shit?
No, I hope so. I love the robot chicken Star Wars shit. I hope so, dude. Yeah, I would love to see that. That shit was great. Both volumes were great. But yeah, so keep your eyes open for that if you're interested in Star Wars.
I heard they dropped like the first episode of The Bad Batch.
Yeah, true? That was today.
I didn't watch it.
You watched it already, Denny? No, I'm gonna watch it today. I didn't watch it yet, but I heard it was good.
Cool. All right. Anything else?
You're in focus week. Is what else?
All right. You know, find some friends to play UFS with.
Good luck. You don't have enough friends.
I don't know. I got no plans. What are you guys doing?
All right. For me, more Digimon. Not just playing, but hunting down more cards. I want some more packs. Buy some for the whole team so we can all have some new ones.
Yeah. The new set is coming out soon.
1.5, right?
Yeah. No, 2.0. 1.5. Oh, yeah. 1.0 is already out. 1.5 is already out. But 2.0 is coming soon in June. And some places are taking pre-orders for it. So maybe we should get on that. June? Pre-orders like 160 is what some people are asking for.
Okay.
So maybe we can split that. Yeah, Wags needs to hurry up.
Yeah, I'm down with more Digimon, so I'm down to play that.
We're over here getting good and shit.
Other things, I want to read more. Like I said it last week, and I still haven't done it. More of that Gore the God Butcher story. I want to keep tearing through that. It's pretty cool. Otherwise, Battlestar Galactica, I want to jump back into it because I've been distracted because of Invincible.
Oh, yeah, more Demon Slayer for me. That's right.
AJ Demon Slayer, yeah.
Read my Sonic the Hedgehog.
I'd like to watch one of those Slayers movies that you have now.
Oh, speaking of Slayers, guys, people that are watching, we have a Slayers review made by T on our Unfocused Podcast channel on YouTube.
Yeah, please start with it. Let us know if you like it. Please like, comment, subscribe, and then maybe more will come out soon.
Yeah, leave some comments and all that too. Yeah, let us know what you like about it, what you don't like.
If it gains traction, I'm more likely to put more shit out and more modern, updated shit.
Oh yeah. Also, I have some videos out because I had some boxes of UFS boxes that I've opened and I filmed and all that. So on my channel, my personal channel, AJ Twist, go look me up over there and check out some of the boxes I've opened.
Check them out. Yeah. AJ Twist.
Especially
channel.
My Yu Yu Hakusho box opening. Go check that shit out because that was weird. That opening was weird. I'll tell you about it afterwards.
Like, stupid weird, as Yusuke would say?
Crazy weird.
That was weird.
All right, but yeah, I guess that's basically Unfocused episode 300, guys. Thanks for joining us for 300 episodes.
300, guys, yeah. By the way, we've been doing this shit for like 13 years?
Yeah, tell your friends about us. Something like that. One of these days, we'll divide these all into a bunch of segments, and we'll fucking make a bunch of money. Because you know, that's how you fucking turn up. Having those short segments, and having a lot of them. Yeah. People like one... They tend to watch all of them. I found out that's the pattern.
I made a small like clip of something that we talked about on our channel too, when we were talking about Sailor Moon on ice. I thought that was a funny conversation we had about that. So I clipped that out and put it as a separate thing.
Good shit. Keep doing that. Keep doing that.
I want to keep doing that, but I always forget. Like, what did we talk about that was funny?
We should, you know, if we had time, we should pick like an hour or two a week besides Unfocused and sit down and just kind of clip out shit that we've talked about.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, we had to plan a day.
Yeah, we do.
We'll think about that.
No, I forgot to mention that I started watching on Digimon Adventure.
Oh, is it good? I haven't seen it yet.
It's pretty good. It's basically they're retelling the story again, but...
Streamlined.
Just different. Like, this time the Digimon are going to reach their mega forms. The one thing I noticed is more violent.
Ooh.
Like, there's a scene where you see this Digimon, like, pick up these other Digimon, and like he's, like, crunching them. He bites them, like... He eats them.
Damn.
And I was like, I don't remember that in Channel 11. Did
you maybe we need to step our game up, AJ. You know, we need to watch this.
The animation is better. You know, the action is better. You know, and I don't know.
I'm glad you told me because I heard it's better and I want to see Digimon Try. And I heard I should watch this first. That's what I was told.
Try is good too, but Try is its own thing.
But I heard that there is some kind of like connection. Is that not true? I heard this.
Okay. Is it as scary as when freaking in the Pokemon series where that Squirtle all checked out Charmander and just biting the fuck out of him and the fucking Squirtle was just crying or the Charmander was just crying?
No, there's a scene where like Ty gets eaten by a Digimon.
Oh, what the shit?
Fucking Metal Greymon goes berserk and the animation is so cool. Like, I was like, fuck.
Is he alive still?
You don't see this in Channel 11.
Show us the clip, bro.
This sounds fucking crazy.
When I saw that, I was like, fuck.
Hey, guys, apparently Digimon Adventure, that's where it's at.
Yeah, man.
Step your game up. Sick. Listen to DJ. All right, you guys, I'm focused.
All right, I'm focused. Thanks for watching. Anything else, guys? I don't think so.
Don't forget, this is a Collision 28 production. We're live on twitch.tv/collision28 every Thursday.
Wednesday.
Also, you can always catch us on youtube.com/unfocusedpodcast to see rebroadcasting of these episodes. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe there as well.
Also, Twitter, you can message us at unfocused28. We also give you updates when the show starts. Instagram at Unfocused Podcast. Subscribe, like.
You can subscribe to our podcast show, the audio version, on Apple Podcasts, or just get more information about that on collision28.com.
Or if you have any comments or things you want us to talk about, or maybe things that you feel we missed in the past, email us on unfocusedpodcast@gmail.com.
Don't forget to subscribe!